so if we continue in the text, the Bible says that he did which was right in the sight of the Lord, and walked in all the way of David his father, and turned not aside to the right hand or to the left. My brothers and sisters, I have to tell you another point about the pretext of the text. My brothers and sisters, the thing that readers tend to leave out when they're reading this particular chapter, and the thing that readers tend to not discover about this chapter, is that before Josiah, the people of Jerusalem were experiencing bad kings. For the past few years, all they knew was evil. All they knew was all of this hell, and all they had was bad kings. But now in chapter number 22, now they have a Josiah. So all of these years, over all of these years, they were experiencing bad kings with Amon and Manasseh. But finally, there is a new king in town. Might I submit to you today that trouble don't last always. And not only does trouble don't last always, but God is still in control. Somebody tell your neighbor, God is still in control. See, the problem that I really have with some people is that people tend to complain about evil as if God didn't allow that evil to happen in the first place. I have a problem with some people who tend to not realize that when bad things happen in your life, God allowed those bad things to happen in your life. See, we have to understand that to everything there's a season, and everything happens for a reason. But I come out here to tell somebody that instead of complaining about how bad things are, instead of complaining about how evil things are, you ought to thank God for Josiah. Because out of all these evil things in your life, eventually God is going to send you a Josiah. Is there anybody in here who is so glad that God is going to send you a Josiah? Is there anybody in here who has been dealing with some evil and wicked things in their life? I just come out here to tell somebody that doors may have been closed in your faith. But that's all right, because God is going to open new doors in your life. People may have said you're too young or too incapable, but I come out here to tell you that God holds the keys to your future. People may have said you wasn't going to make it, but I come out here to tell somebody that in due time, God is going to see you through after a while. Is there anybody in here who's so glad that God is going to make it all right after a while? I come out here to tell somebody that a new king is in town. Somebody tell your neighbor, a new king is in town. I am a royal priesthood, a royal people, a peculiar people, a holy nation. Now you got to show forth the praise to the God that brought you out of the darkness into the marvelous light. Now I come out here to tell somebody that you may have been dealing with evil. You may have been dealing with bad relationships. You may have been dealing with trials and tribulation. Well, keep on dealing with it. Keep on going through it, because eventually God is preparing something new for you. And eventually when God says so, he is going to set things straight and send you a Josiah. Can I get a witness? Eventually, God is going to set things straight and send you a Josiah. My brothers and sisters, so if we look in the text, the Bible says that Josiah did what was right in the sight of the Lord. And also he walked in the right path and did not turn to the right or to the left. My brothers and sisters, the difference between Josiah and the other two kings is that Josiah stayed in step with God. The Bible says that he did what was right in the sight of the Lord, and he also did not turn to the right or to the left in his walk of life. See, my brothers and sisters, I'm not promising you prosperity for your whole walk in this life. I'm not promising you that things are always going to be good in your walk of life, but I can promise you that if you just stay in step with God, then God is going to get you to where you need to be. Can I get a witness in here? See, Jesus said when he was praying at Gethsemane, not as I will, Lord, but as you will. Is there anybody in here who is saying yes, Lord, to your will? Is there anybody in here who is telling God yes to your commandments, yes to your plan, yes to whatever you want me to do? Lord, I'll give up my plan for your plan. Is there anybody in here who is saying yes, Lord, to your will? I see tribulations. I see shackles in your path. But I come out here to tell somebody that don't mean nothing. You still will get to where you need to be if you stay and step with God. See, you have to learn to take the limits off yourself. You got to learn to just take the limits off yourself and be everything that you ever aspired to be. The Bible says that if you got faith the size of a mustard seed, then you can move a mountain. Somebody tell your neighbor, don't get it twisted. Don't get it messed up. Don't get it wrong either. I'm not too young to leave. But God has put something inside of me to be everything I wanted to be. I come out here to tell the youth today that God has put something on the inside of you to aspire to everything you want to be. The only thing stopping you is doubting yourself. But you gotta have faith that you can do anything if you got God on your side. Is there anybody here who got faith that if you just keep on walking, that God is gonna get you to where you need to be? See, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Now somebody hop out your neighbor and say, neighbor, this only for the people who got faith. If you got faith, tell your neighbor, I believe God for my future. I believe God for my healing. I believe God for my breakthrough. I believe God for my deliverance. I believe that if I just stay and step with God, then God is going to get me to where I need to be. I know it's not looking good right now, but God is going to fix it after a while. If you just stay and step with God, people may get out your life. People may turn their back on you. People may snake you and say you're not going to make it. But you just got to keep and stay and step with God. Bills may not be paid. Your life may get cut off. But you just got to stay and step with God. Because if you keep on praying, God is going to respond after a while. If you keep saying hallelujah, if you keep saying thank you, Jesus, if you keep walking when you're supposed to fall down, God is going to fix it after a while. That if you haven't already, you need to tell the Lord yes. Yes to your will, and in God I trust. I come out here to tell somebody that you may have been born to lose because you entered into this world of sin. But I come out here to say that you are built to win. You got it on the inside of you. You got it on the inside of you to be everything you want to be. You may have been born to lose, but you are built to win. Somebody say, you ain't seen nothing yet, but God is about to do something in my life.